I did not know Gauri Lankesh personally. I did not have the good fortune to do so. But of course, I knew of her work, and I followed her writings, whatever appeared in English at length. Gauri was one of the few people who very early on recognized how the project, the specter of terrorism, was very central to this project of terrorism. She started writing about this in early 2008, late 2007, when many of our very well-intentioned friends were also calling for an equivalence between CINIA and RSS and saying that there must be a recognition of bad apples within the community and so on. And deferring to the idea of national security and nation state and so on, that nobody was willing to question the large number of frame-ups that were happening in terror cases against Muslim youth. Gauri was one of the few people who broke out of this and started questioning. If you look at her writings from 2007-2008, in early 2008 she wrote a piece called Karnataka is Turning into the Gujarat of South India. And there she talks about communal violence and also, but she starts by writing how three young Muslim men have been picked up for vehicle theft and then implicated in a terror case. And she looks at great detail how the press, both the liberal English media as well as the very pro-Hindutva Kannada magazines like Udayavani and so on, were reporting on it. She's very caustic. She's very scathing with both of them. She calls out, for example, the Hindu for saying that because these three young men have some knowledge of law, it seems that they are not ordinary people. And you know, she questions these kind of premises that were part of that sort of reporting. Or, for example, the Times of India making front page headlines about how because these men were offering namaz 5 times a day, they were bound to be terrorists. She called reportage out, and she played a great role in that period when there was nobody to question this whole narrative of terrorism. Gauri was one of the few lone people making those kinds of interventions and questions in the public sphere there. Now, in 2012, we brought out a report called Frame Damned Acquitted in Delhi, which looked at the special cell cases in Delhi where the special cell had said that these people were, Houthi or LET terrorists and so on, and all of these people got acquitted later, some years later on. So, just when we had released it, there was a very sensational case in Bangalore. 15 Muslim boys were picked up and they were charged with what some mischievous journalists or security analysts called the Bangalore Jihad case, whereas the police itself called it the Bangalore assassination case. Now, all of these 15 people were picked up and the prosecution story was that there was a big assassination plot to murder right-wing journalists and leaders, Pramod Muttalik among others, and that this was touted as this great terror conspiracy of Karnataka. And 6 months later, three of those young men were released. Muthiur Rehman Siddiqui was a journalist, and another DRDO scientist, another boy. Three of them were discharged two of them were discharged and one was released on bail. Now, I kind of recall this case for two reasons. One is that this was an assassination attempt. No assassination took place, but it was an assassination plot. And yet the charges that these people were charged under were terror. The terror legislation was invoked. So now I think today it is time, as B.T. Venkatesh, her lawyer, has said, that Gauri Lankesh's murder must be recognized as an act of terror. We must demand that it is recognized that there were, because it is, as many of these social media tweets and so on have also said, that this is, it is an act which is intended to create terror and fear amongst all people who speak up. So it must be recognized as such and prosecuted as such. But I also recall a 2012 case for another reason, because there was a journalist, as I said, who was picked up and later discharged though. But Gauri Lankesh had written extensively on that case as well. And when Muthiur Rehman was released, She lamented the fact that no journalist organization or association had stood by him. She wrote that not only nobody did not stand with him, but many journalists actually went out to impute that he was a mastermind. So she had that great capacity to confront, you know, our deepest kind of prejudices, you know, in us. And it is with, and you know, there is several people have spoken about how and whether this case will come to fruition or not, we do not know. Shahid Azmi's killers, Shahid Azmi was murdered in 2010. And at that time, the police, the Bombay police, said the first reaction of the Bombay police was, oh, it's the handiwork of the nationalists or the patriotic underworld. And it is now 7 years later that charges have been filed, that charges have been framed. So we don't know which way the case will go. But I only want to say that let it not be these sporadic one or two of protests. We must follow these cases through, and it's not just Gauri's case. There are many, many other cases. And before Gauri in Karnataka, there was Naushad Kashimji, the lawyer who was defending many of the accused in terror cases, was gunned down in 2009. And it's a pattern that we see everywhere. So there must be a very, you know, concerted effort to make, to ensure that these cases are brought to justice, that justice is done. Because, you know, we should not go back satisfied that we've done a protest today and this is the end of it. There should be a following of the cases. But in the end, I also want to say something in deep anger, not against the BJP RSS, which is there, of course, but also against our political parties who are supposedly, you know, anti-BJP, anti-RSS and so on. Is it the job of the civil society alone to fight the RSS-BJP? I mean, will it only be the civil society who will be calling for protests, organizing Not In My Name or other kinds of protests, journalists, writers, teachers, students, filmmakers? Where is, I mean, the political parties, I think, owe us something, and we should demand answers from them as well. Thank you.